hybridization. Okay, so the concept of hybridization is used in valence bond theory, and here in case of the molecular orbital theory, we are going to use this concept called as the Yeltsin approximation, which is nothing but the linear combination of atomic orbitals. Okay, so what are the postulates of this? So we discuss this diagram in last lecture. So what happens, suppose say two atoms, okay, or you can say that the atomic orbitals of two atoms, they can combine by means of the Yeltsin approximation. Okay, so they can combine via two phenomena. First one is what, say, the attraction, another is nothing but said to be the repulsion. So see here, this diagram, it is nothing but said to be AOs of the first atom. This is what the AOs of the second atom. So we will consider what, say, the H2 molecule. So this is nothing but said to be the atomic orbital, that is nothing but the 1s orbital of H. Okay, this is the 1s orbital of another hydrogen. So when the wave function of this orbital, okay, there is a, say, the attraction in between. The attraction can be shown by the positive sign. So when there is attraction, so what we got? We got the BMOs. Yesterday I told you what is BMO. BMO is bonding molecular orbital. Okay, bonding molecular orbitals. Conversely, what happen when the same wave function, if there is a repulsion in between them? Okay, so the repulsion can be shown by, say, the negative charge. Okay, or you can say the negative sign. Okay, so they can form what, say, the ABMOs. What is ABMOs? ABMOs is nothing but anti-bonding molecular orbitals. Okay, both they are, means what, BMOs and ABMOs, they are called as what, say, the MOs. What is MOs? MOs are nothing but said to be molecular orbitals. Okay, so molecular orbitals are nothing but the orbital of molecule. Okay, and these are nothing but said to be the AOs, which are called as the atomic orbitals, which is recognized, or you can say that which is nothing but the part of the atom. So these are nothing but the orbitals of the atom. This is also the orbitals of the atom, and this one and this one, or you can say that these are nothing but, say, the orbitals of what, say, the molecule. Okay, so we have two phenomena. First one is what, say, attraction, shown by here positive sign. Another phenomena is what, say, the repulsion. Okay, so the repulsion is shown by, say, the negative sign. So suppose we have two atomic orbitals. So when there is a attraction, so we got what, say, the bonding molecular orbital. When there is a repulsion, so we got what, say, the anti-bonding molecular orbital. Yesterday I already told you, when there is a attraction, so what happened, their energy will going to fall down. Okay, so that when we compare the energy of the anti-bonding molecular orbital with what, say, the bonding molecular orbital, so obviously the bonding molecular orbitals, they are lie at the bottom, or you can say that at the down. Okay, and anti-bonding molecular orbitals always present at the upper side, and bonding molecular orbital always present at the lower side. So this is nothing but said to be the case. So due to the attraction of what, say, the AOs, attraction of what, say, the AOs, so what we got? We got, say, the BMOs, bonding molecular orbital, which having comparatively less energy. Okay, and when, say, the repulsion in between them, so we got what, say, the anti-bonding molecular orbital, which having the higher energy. So that concept is well explained by constructing this molecular orbital diagram of H2 molecule. Okay, so see here, this is nothing but, say, hydrogen, one hydrogen over here, another hydrogen over here. Okay, why? Because we are going to react these two hydrogens. What we got the H2 molecule. Okay, this is what, say, the energy axis. So this is first energy axis of first hydrogen. This is second axis of second hydrogen, where we put their orbital. Okay, so the hydrogen, they having electronic configuration is 1s1. Okay, 1s1. So they have the 1s orbital, and they having one unpaired electron each. Okay, so these are nothing but said to be, say, the position of 1s orbital. After that, this is what, say, the 1s orbital. We have what, the one unpaired electron each. Okay, then according to the Yeltsin approximation, when two orbitals, two 1s orbitals, they you can say that reacted. How they react? By means of two phenomena. Okay, you cannot say forget about that. Okay, this is what, say, the basic concept of what, say, the molecular orbital theory, called as what, linear combination of atomic orbitals. Okay, so the in linear combination of atomic orbitals, atomic orbitals are reacted by means of two ways. If there is a, say, attraction, or there is a repulsion. Okay, If there is attraction, we got bonding molecular orbital. If there is a repulsion, so we got a yes. What we got? We got say the anti-bonding molecular orbital. This one. So this is what say the attraction. So due to attraction, we got what say the bonding, so that the energy will fall down. This is what say the repulsion. So the if there is a repulsion in between the these two, if there is the repulsion between this and this orbital, so the energy will going to rise. Okay, and here we have the anti-bonding. Here we have say the bonding like this. This is what say the bonding orbital. This is what say the anti-bonding molecular orbital. This one, both electrons are filled over here. And filling of the electron can be take place according to the rules given in inorganic chemistry. So we have three rules. The first one is what above principle. Second is nothing but said to be the Hund's rule is there. And third one is the Pauli's principle. So we have three rules. What is above principle? We have to fill electron according to the increasing order of their energy. Means suppose we have two orbitals. I will going to explain. See, this is what say the one orbital. Okay, this is the another orbital. Which one is having lower energy? This one. Okay, this one. Means this one is what say the sigma 1s, which is having what say the less energy. So according to the above principle, we have to fill these two electron into this. Why? Because the capacity of this orbital is of two electrons. So we have to put both electron into this orbital. Okay, and this orbital must be vacant, and this orbital is called about sigma star. So whatever, whenever say we have to you can say that they nominate the anti-bonding molecular orbital, so we can nominate by sigma star, or you can say that just star. Either they may have suppose sigma or they have pi. Okay, so we have two types of bond, either sigma or pi. So anti-bonding is sigma star or pi star. Okay, so the two types of anti-bonding orbitals we have in our MOT diagram. Okay, so up to this we already explained in last lecture. I will just remind it. Okay, the next, yeah, this one is nothing but similar diagram of H2 molecule. Here we have what say this is what hydrogen, first hydrogen, they having electronic configuration 1s1. This is an another hydrogen which having same electronic configuration 1s1. Okay, so this is what say the one hydrogen, they having one unpaired electron. This is another hydrogen, they having unpaired electron. Okay, so when they undergo say the LC approximation, so due to the attraction, we got what this sigma HH, that is what the sigma 1s orbital. Okay, which having less energy, that is called as what the stabilization due to the bonding. So these are what bonding electrons. And when there is repulsion in between them, we got what this orbital called as what the sigma star orbital. Okay, so we can say that a destabilization. Why? Because the energy will going to rise, increase. That's why it's called as the destabilization. Okay, this orbital is called as the anti-bonding molecular orbital. This orbital is called as what? Say the bonding molecular orbital. Okay, and finally, say we have to write down the MO electronic configuration. So you already seen over here. This is what say how to write down this H2 molecule equals to sigma 1s2. What is sigma 1s2? So the orbital is nominated as sigma 1s. How? Because it is formed due to the combination of 1s 1s orbital. Hence it is abbreviated as sigma 1s, and they have two electrons. So we can put these two over here like this in superscript. Okay, we don't have facility over here. Okay, so we have to put this at superscript. So it is nothing but sigma 1s2. It mentioned that we have the sigma 1s orbital and they contain two electrons. Okay, here is sigma star 1s. This is an anti-bonding molecular orbital. They don't have electron, means it is vacant. So either you can write what say the zero over here, or you do not write any digit over here. So this is what say the MO electronic configuration. Now we move towards what say the important concept called as what say the bond order. Okay, bond order. So what is bond order? So bond order is nothing but said to be you can write down it. We have also that formula in next slide. Bond order is nothing but the number of electrons present in bonding orbital minus number of electrons present in the anti-bonding molecular orbital divided by 2. This is nothing but the formula. Have you got this? Number of electrons present in bonding minus number of electrons present in anti-bonding divided by 2. This is what say the formula by which we are able to calculate calculate say the bond order of any molecule. Okay, so here in H2 molecules, we have say two electrons in bonding molecular orbital and none of electrons in say the antibonding molecular orbital. So the equation is like that, 2 minus 0 divided by 2. So it should be 2 by 2. 2 by 2 means what? 1. So that the bond order of H2 molecule is 1. And we know that there is only one sigma bond in between the two hydrogen atoms. Okay, the next is that just by observing this diagram, okay, just by observing this diagram, so we know that this bonding pair is exactly present at the center, okay, at the center of what, these two hydrogen. Okay, so that we can say locate the position of this bonding pair. This is nothing but set with the bonding pair, okay, and it is present exactly center, exact center, okay. So that we can say that this bonding pair is present in between the two hydrogen, or you can say that at the equidistance from two hydrogen atoms. So that's why with the help of the molecular orbital theory, we are able to locate the exact position of bonding electrons in bond. Okay, that cannot done with the help of say the VBT, that is valence bond theory. Then next, this is all about what, say the H2 molecule. Okay, next is what say the difference. Yeah, this question is most important, can be asked in examination. See what the difference between what, say the BMOs and EBMOs. Okay, so what is BMOs? BMOs is what, bonding molecular orbitals. Okay, and EBMOs is nothing but said to be the anti-bonding molecular orbitals. So the first thing is nothing but said to be the bonding molecular orbital, and here we have say the points related to the antibonding molecular orbital. So the first point is nothing but it is formed by the addition overlap of the atomic orbitals. Okay, I already told you what. So say when we had two atomic orbitals, okay, 1s 1s of H hydrogen, okay, and suppose is there attraction, so we can say that what, addition is there, addition, plus plus sign, okay, plus plus addition is there. Okay, so in case of the BMOs, bonding molecular orbital, so the bonding molecular formed by the say the attraction, or you can say that the addition of what, say the two AOs. This is first point. Conversely, suppose if you know that point, so the conversely, in case of the antibonding molecular orbital, it can be formed by the subtraction. Okay, means there is a repulsion. So we are using with the minus sign in case of the antibonding molecular orbital. Okay, so here it is formed by the subtraction. So there is a repulsion in between what, say, two AOs. That's why we got the antibonding molecular orbital. See here, we have very say the simple concept I told you. Okay, whatever the things related to the bonding molecular orbital, so it is exactly opposite to that of the antibonding molecular orbital. It is formed due to the addition of the orbitals. It is formed due to the subtraction of the orbitals. This is what, say, the first difference. Second, it may or may not have node. Okay, so what is node? Okay, so I will tell you. Have you seen the p orbital? Okay, have you seen, say, the p orbital? P orbital is having what, dumbbell shape. Okay, means what, upper lobe and lower lobe. So in between the two lobe, okay, so we don't have say electron density. Okay, I think you got what I'm saying. Okay, if you know say the shape of the p orbital, it should be dumbbell. They're having upper lobe and lower lobe. In between them, the positions where the probability of finding the electron is a zero, or you can say that is minimum, that position is called as the node. Okay, suppose we have suppose slide, so I will tell you what is node. So in bonding molecular orbital, they may or may not. Okay, means tyachyamadhye asu pan shakte ani tyachyamadhye nasu pan shakte. Pan antibonding cha samjha tumhi vichar kela tar antibonding madhye asnarach asnar. Antibonding molecular orbital, they must have a node. Yachyat node asnar mhanje asnar, rahnarach. So this is what, say, the second difference in between, say, the bonding and antibonding. So in case of the bonding, we have a node, or may not. Okay, but in case of the antibonding, we always have a node. Okay, so this is what, say, the second difference. Third, is nothing but in this orbital, the electron density is more in between the nuclei. Okay. And the electrons in these orbitals lead to attraction between the atoms. Okay. So what is the meaning of this? Okay. And in case of the antibonding molecular, in this orbital, the electron density is less in between the nuclei, and the electrons in the orbitals lead to the repulsion between atoms. What happen? Suppose we have two atoms. Okay, I will tell you what do you mean by this. We have two atoms. We can join this like this. The electron density will be present at the center in case of the bonding molecular orbital. And in case of the antibonding, the electron density will be present at the this side. Means it is not present at the center. Means they are present like this. Okay, this is bond. Okay, like this, electron density will be present over here. In bonding, suppose this is bond, electron density present over here, like this, in between two atoms. So this is nothing but said to be the difference in between these two. Okay, do not much try to understand this. You just have to read this. Okay, understand this, but read. You have to read this. Okay. The next is what the electron in these orbitals contribute to the formation of bond. Yes, obviously. Whatever the electron density present in the bonding molecular orbital, so they result bond. Okay, as we already seen in the H2 molecule, we have two electrons in sigma 1s. So this is what's the bonding electron density. Due to that two electrons, we have a bond in between the two hydrogen atom. Okay, and in case of the antibonding orbital jar hatat, tacha mude bond form nahi hot. Bond ha fakt bonding orbital mudas form hotat. Lakshat thevayche. Bonding orbital madhe jeva electron rahatat, so they can form a bond. Antibonding ha bond form karat nahi. Okay, lakshat thevayche kadhi marathit sangto. Okay, to bond form karat nahi. Bond fakt kon form karte? Bonding molecular orbital form karta. Okay, antibonding karat nahi. The next is what the energy is less. So who already know that bonding orbital, bonding molecular orbital, they having less energy. Okay, and antibonding is having the higher energy. Okay, why? Because they can form due to the addition, they can form due to the repulsion, so that there is energy difference. Obviously, the represented without asterisk. Okay, so I will tell you what. Whenever we write down, say the bonding molecular orbitals, we can write down sigma, pi, like this. Whenever we write down what, say the antibonding molecular orbital, so we can use what sigma star, pi star, like this. Okay, so this is what say the another difference. The bonding molecular orbital say represented without asterisk, and antibonding molecular orbital they can represented with asterisk. Means what sigma star, star like. Okay, so asterisk means star. Okay, so we are not using that star in bonding molecular orbital. Now we are using to show what say the antibonding molecular orbital. So these are what say the five different points which can differentiate the bonding as well as the antibonding molecular orbitals. Next, now we have to talk about what say the combination of the orbitals and shape of the bonding as well as the say the bonding as well as antibonding molecular orbital. This is an you can say that you will be this will be included in your syllabus. So so that I will going to say show that. See, this is say we know that first thing is nothing but said to be the 1s orbital. So we try to understand the interaction in between the 1s orbital, that is what's the bonding and antibonding. We already discussed this. Okay, see, this is we know that we have the four orbitals, that is what s, p, d and f. Okay, the meaning of this orbital is s for sharp, p for principal, d for diffuse, f for fundamental. You can write down it. Okay, they can be asked in the competitive examination. Okay, of our chemistry. S for sharp, P for principal, D for diffuse, and F for fundamental. Okay, so we have what is four orbitals. Okay, see, there is a difference in between the orbit and orbitals. What is orbit? Orbit means main shell, K, L, M, N, and orbitals means subshell. There we have four subshell only, S, P, D, F. Okay, so we have to say think about what's the shape. Combination of the SPDF and then the shape of the bonding and antibonding orbitals derive from the combination of SPD and F. Okay, so I started from what the SS orbital, So suppose we know that the shape of the S orbital is spherical. Okay, so we have the spherical shape. Okay, so when SS orbital will combine, so two types of phenomena we got. So I already told you about, say, the addition. We also got like the attraction. And here third thing is nothing but, see, this is what the S orbital. This is another S orbital. We have the constructive interference. What is constructive? When constructive interference, when suppose we have a wave like this, wave sine wave, okay, like the sine wave. So when both having, so the wave is having what, the crest and trough, you know that, okay. So when two waves are interacted, okay, so they can form two types of phenomena. First one is what, a constructive. Second is what, the destructive phenomena. Okay, so what is constructive and what is destructive? When what, the crest and trough will you can say that merge, they comes in contact. Okay, means the crust of one wave and crust of the another wave, like this. That will be called as what, say, the constructive phenomena. Okay, another is nothing but said to be the destructive. So what is destructive? Crust of one, trough of one, like this. That is destructive. Another another name, I think in physics you may heard this, in phase, out of phase. Okay, like this. In phase means like this. Okay, two waves. Okay, out of phase means like this. Okay, so here we have seen what, two phenomena. First one is what, the constructive phenomena. So whenever the constructive phenomena take place, so there is an addition or there is an attraction in between the two waves. Okay, and what we got, say, the bonding molecular orbital, and the shape will be like this. Okay, see, here the electron density will be present over here at the center of that bond. Okay, and when there is a destructive phenomena, okay, so what happened, there is a repulsion will be take place, or you can say that the subtraction will be take place. Okay, and now what happened, when there is a subtraction, so the electron density will be present over here, here and here. Okay, here there is no electron density at this position, so that's why it is called as the node. Okay, I will tell you what node. See, what this is, what, say, the positions where the electron density is, you can say that the minimum, okay, or zero. Okay, so that position is called about the node. The node is the positions where the probability of finding the electron is zero or minimum. I will repeat it. Node is the position where the probability of finding the electron is zero. म्हणजे जिथे इलेक्ट्रॉन सापडण्याची शक्यता कमी राहते किंवा नसते त्या पोझिशनला आपण काय म्हणत असतो, नोड म्हणतो. ठीक आहे, सो दॅट इज व्हॉट से द अँटी बॉन्डिंग मॉलिक्युलर ऑर्बिटल. सो एस ऑर्बिटल कॅन कंबाईन व्हाय टू वेज, आयदर बाय कन्स्ट्रक्टिव्ह ऑर डिस्ट्रक्टिव्ह फिनॉमिना, अँड वी गॉट द मॉलिक्युलर एज वेल एज द अँटी बॉन्डिंग ऑर मॉलिक्युलर, यू कॅन से द बॉन्डिंग मॉलिक्युलर ऑर द अँटी बॉन्डिंग मॉलिक्युलर ऑर्बिटल्स वी इज कोल्ड. ओके, next slide is related to the combination of S and P. Okay, so see here, what happened here, I think so I think here there is no S SP orbital combination. This is nothing but said to be the PP orbital. Okay, it is what, say, the PP orbital. So the P orbital, you know that this is what, say, there is a correction. Okay, here we have not SP, we have, say, the PP orbital. Okay, so what happened when we have, say, the p orbital is having dumbbell shape. Okay, so I already told you what this is, what, say, the p orbital, this is what, one lobe. Okay, this is another lobe. Okay, and this is nothing but the position. See what, this black spot, okay, where the probability of finding the electron is zero, so that position is called as the node. Okay, so that p orbital can be interacted with one another via two ways. Okay, the first way is nothing but said to be the internuclear axis overlapping. Yesterday I told you what is internuclear axis overlapping. So this is what said to be the internuclear axis, this one, this dotted line. Okay, this one is the internuclear axis. So when this orbitals there can interacted like this, okay, so we can call as what, the internuclear axis overlapping. Okay, and due to this internuclear axis overlapping, we got what, the sigma bond. Okay, so seen over here, sigma MOs, that is what, sigma molecular orbital. This one is what, a plus plus sign. So it means what, plus plus means addition. Okay, addition is there, attraction is there, plus plus. Here is what, a plus minus or minus plus. Okay, So this is what is the internuclear excess overlapping. So obviously we got what, the sigma bond. See, whenever we got the sigma bond, whenever we got pi bond, so whenever the internuclear excess overlapping, we got the sigma bond. Whenever the lateral overlapping, so we got the pi bond. Okay, so here the plus plus is the overlapping, so we got the the bonding molecular orbital. It is abbreviated as sigma, MOS, sigma. Okay, so it is a sigma, so that's what is bonding. Okay, here is the plus minus is overlapping, so that we got say this one is node. See what, this is node, and we know that the node always present in the anti-bonding molecular orbital. So obviously it is sigma star. See here, this is a sigma star molecular orbital. So this is what, anti-bonding molecular orbital. This is what, say, the bonding molecular orbital. Okay, so this is what, say, the combination of the pp orbital. Okay, we got what, bonding as well as anti-bonding molecular orbital. Yeah, see this one, this also we have correction. So we have the pp orbital combination. Okay, so we have correction over here. Okay, so see what happened here. We already seen the combination of the p orbital. So p orbital can be combined by means of two ways, either by the internuclear axis overlapping or by, say, the lateral overlapping. Okay, so this diagram shows what, say, the lateral overlapping, or you can say that the sidewise overlapping. Okay, when there is a sidewise overlapping, or you can say the plus plus and minus minus can overlap, so it should be, you can say that the addition, okay, constructive phenomena or addition phenomena or the attraction phenomena. What we got, bonding molecular orbital. So this is what, the bonding molecular orbital, they have a node. Obviously they have a node, because in the say the difference in between the bonding and anti-bonding, we already discussed the bonding molecular orbital, they may or may not, म्हणजे असू पण शकते आणि नसू पण शकते, पण अँटी बॉन्डिंग मध्ये नोड हा असणारच. ओके, तर मग कसं, सी व्हाट, व्हेनेवर वी मूव टुवर्ड्स द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ द पी ऑर्बिटल बाय मीन्स ऑफ द साइडवाइज ओव्हरलॅपिंग, वी गॉट व्हाट, से द पाय ऑर्बिटल. आय ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू. ओके, अँड देर इज अ नोड इन बिटवीन दीज टू, से दिस इज व्हॉट इज प्लस वेव साईन अँड दिस इज व्हॉट द मायनस वेव साईन. ओके, दिस इज द इंटरन्युक्लिअर ऍक्सिस ओव्हरलॅपिंग. This is an internuclear axis. They can overlap sidewise, so that we got the pi bond. Okay, we got pi bond, and that one is called as what, a nodal plane. You can say that the in between the two lobes. Okay, we got what, say, the nodal plane, where the probability of finding the electron is, you can say that is zero. Next is nothing but yes, this one. There is a combination of what, a plus minus and minus plus. So obviously, whenever we have, so it is a destructive phenomena. Okay, another we call as subtraction, or another repulsion. Okay, so these are nothing but three different names. Okay, what we got? We got always anti-bonding molecular orbital. So this is what, say, the anti-bonding molecular orbital, denoted by the pi star molecular orbital. See what, this is pi star. Okay, this one is pi star. Obviously, it is an anti-bonding molecular orbital, and they have in the two nodal plane. This one, okay, and that one. They have in the two node. You can say that node. Okay. So this is what, say, the combination of the pp orbital. So remember that pp orbital can be interacted via two ways. The first one is what, internuclear axis overlapping, another is what, the lateral overlapping. When they interact by the internuclear axis overlapping, so we got the sigma bond. Okay, so when there is a plus plus sign will overlap, we got the sigma. Okay, and a plus minus sign will overlap, we got what, say, the sigma star. Okay, this is what the first thing. Another way is nothing but the sidewise overlapping. When there is a sidewise overlapping, plus plus, okay, so we got what, say, the pi. Okay, so we have the one node there. When there is a, say, the plus minus sign will going to overlap, okay, plus minus sign will go overlap, sidewise overlapping, so we got what, the pi star. Okay, and they having what, the two nodes. Okay, so that much matter we discuss in this slide. Okay, next slide. Yeah, it is an pd overlapping. Okay, so this is an d orbital, this is an d orbital. Okay, and this one is what, say, the p orbital. Okay, so we don't have much work with this. Okay, it is just, and this one is what, the metal is having what, say, the d orbital, and this one is ligand, they having the p orbital, and there is a say the combination. Okay, so internuclear axis overlapping is there. Okay, so they can result what, say, the lateral overlapping. Yeah, obviously lateral, they can form a pi bond. If there is a lateral overlapping, they can form a pi bond. Okay, see, this is what, say, the dd overlapping. Dd means d orbital. Okay, dd means d orbital of one thing and another is having d orbital. So the linear combination of the molecular orbital. So you can say that a pi dd. So the pi bond will be formed. This is nothing but lateral overlapping. This is what sideways. This is lateral overlapping. This orbital will be formed, new pi. And this one, there is a node in between this. Okay, so that's what is called the pi. Pi dd, because it can be formed due to the combination of dd orbital. So that's why this can, this slide can show what's the dd orbital combination according to the you can see that linear combination. Yeah, rules of the linear combination of the atomic orbitals.